This video will show you how to use the new printing system that you'll find at both Foothill and De Anza colleges. The first thing you need to do is get your student ID card. This is required to activate your account. The second thing you must do is log into your account and add funds. To get started, go to the Students tab and scroll down to the bottom of the middle column and you'll see the ePRINTit account. Click on the upload link. The login screen will ask you for your username and password. Initially, your username is your 8-digit ID and your password is also your 8-digit ID. Once you have added funds to your account, please make sure that you go back and click on the change password link so you can put in a more secure password. Before you can print, you need to add funds to your account. The best way to do this is to go to the Add Funds tab in the web application, and here you can enter your credit card and add $5, $10, $15, or $20 to your account. Then when you go to the print station, it'll take the money out of your account and it'll also print the documents you select from your account. The first thing you'll see when you log in is the Home tab. Here you can use the Browse button to go in and find documents on your desktop or on your computer, and then click the Upload button, which will upload the document to your account. Before you get started, you need to take a look at the document that you want to print. It must be one of these file types, and also the name of the file cannot contain any special characters and only one dot or period, which should be just before the extension. Finally, the file name must be 5 characters or longer. Password protected PDF documents will only print if you create a version of the file that doesn't have a password. If you're on a Windows computer, you need to open the document on your computer after entering the password. Now print the document, but select .xps as the printer. The system will then ask you for a file name and where to save it. If you're on an Apple computer, the first thing to do is to launch the preview application, which is pre-installed on all of the campus computers. Open the PDF and enter the password. Now you can save the document as a PDF, however, the password will no longer be attached. Another way to upload documents to your ePRINTit account is to email them as an attachment to fhda@eprintit.com. It is important that you use your preferred personal email account that the college uses to communicate with you. ePRINTit uses that email address to connect to your account. A third method for getting a document to the printer is to save it on a USB device. It is important that you follow all the rules in terms of the file types and no special characters. Are you ready to print? Here is a list of the print stations on both campuses. The first screen, you need to touch Print Your Documents, and you can always go back to this screen by touching the Home button. Now the menu screen will display, and to access documents that you've either uploaded or emailed to your ePRINTit account, touch the Foothill-De Anza button on the upper right-hand corner. If your document is on a USB device, simply touch the USB button in the upper left-hand corner. There are 4 basic screens. However, the order in which they appear depends on whether or not you're using a USB or accessing documents that you've loaded up into your ePRINTit account. This is the login screen. It is how you tell the system about your ePRINTit account. There's a card reader on the right side of the screen. Here you can swipe your student ID card with a magnetic stripe facing forward, or you can also type in your ID and password. If you're using a USB device, after you've selected the documents you want to print, when it's time to pay, this screen will display. When it is time to select the documents you want to print, all of the files available in your ePRINTit account will display. An example is the screenshot on the lower left. If you're using a USB device, the screen on the upper right displays. Touch a folder to open it. Select documents you want to print by touching them. Then touch the Print button or the Next button. The next display is a preview of the documents you want to print. Here you can confirm that the correct documents are selected. At the top of the screen, you can select black and white or color, and one-sided or two-sided pages. To the left, you can select the number of copies per document. Use the red minus and the blue plus signs to select the number of copies. The default is one copy, one-sided, black and white. The top right of the screen displays the amount of money in your account, unless you're using a USB device. In that case, you will be asked to log into your account after you've selected the documents to be printed. Then your account balance will display. When all of the settings are correct, touch the next button. Now it is time to pay. Simply touch the Pay to Print button and the cost of printing will be deducted from your account. The Pay button is only enabled on the kiosk in the campus center. It is better to add funds to your account using the web application rather than the print station where you will be holding up other students who need to print. If you're using a USB device, you will now be asked to log into your account. Now you will see your funds deducted and then the print screen. You don't have to do anything. Just retrieve your printout from the printer. And if you used a USB, make sure you take that out of the station also. There's actually another way to print. There's a smartphone app for Apple, Android, and BlackBerry devices. Make sure you download the HP ePrint Enterprise app by looking for the logo displayed here. This app uses the HP public network, which you can access on the menu screen. Detailed instructions can be found in the ePrintit account channel on the Students tab. That's it for now, so have a great quarter.